Ricky, do you mind if I don't go to your show tonight?
Don't go?
The show is wonderful, and I just love the numbers you do. But, you know, after seeing it so many times, it does get a little boring. Do you mind if I don't go tonight, Ethel and I?
No, of course not, honey. What should I mind?
Good. I thought we might go to a movie.
Sure, that's a good idea. Go have a little dinner and then go to a movie. And what do you mean my show is boring?
Oh, well, honey, I didn't mean it was really boring. But, you know, after seeing it so many times, it's... Well, after 20 or 30 times, it does get a little...
Yes?
Well, let's put it this way. Your show is so great, I just can't stand the excitement of seeing it one more time.
That's better. Oh. That's better?
Hi, Rick.
Oh, hi, hi.
Hi. We better get down for the dinner show, Rick.
Yeah, okay, I'll be right with you.
Hey, Ethel. Ethel, how would you like to have dinner and go to a movie with me tonight?
Oh, I'd love to. But how did you get us out of the, S-H-O-W?
Oh, Ethel, he can't pronounce English, but he can spell it.
You're a dying tooth and I can. If there's one thing I know how to do, is how to S-P-E-L.
How do you like that? All these years, I could have been spelling in front of him. I'll get my thing.
Hey, Rick, there's something that I want to... Well, I better tell you.
Yeah, what is it, Fred?
Well, I was going over the books and... Well, you know that money isn't everything. And you also know that anyone can make a mistake.
Well, what's going on?
Well, you remember how I told you back in Rome that we'd cleared $3,000?
Yeah?
Well, I checked the figures again, and when I jiggled the paper for what I thought were decimal points, fell off. That must have been dirt or something. So we didn't make quite... 3,000.
Well, how much did we make?
300.
300? Fred, when I hire a band manager, I hire somebody to handle things, not to louse them up.
Well, I'm sorry, Rick, but these things just happen.
Well, there's been too many of these dumb things just happening. I might have just as well had Lucy for a band manager.
Well, you don't have to get nasty.
What do you mean? What do you mean you might just as well have had Lucy for a band? And what do you mean? You don't have to get nasty. What's going on?
Three guesses who goofed.
What did I do?
Not you, Fred, the boy wonder of Wall Street.
Oh. Well, look, we'll have to go over the books tomorrow and see exactly where we stand.
Come on, we'll be late for the show.
Okay. I'll go get my coat.
I got a wonderful idea. Let's you and I go to the Monte Carlo Casino tonight.
Oh, let's do. We couldn't leave without seeing the most famous gambling casino in the world.
And who knows, we might be the first Americans who ever broke the bank at Monte Carlo.
You're not gonna broke no bank nowhere.
Why not?
Because I don't want you to go to the casino.
Why not?
Because I don't want you to gamble.
Oh, honey, just a few dollars. I might win.
That would be worse. Like my father used to say, el dinero que se gana jugando no te hace ningún bien. Y si te encuentro jugando, no te vas a poder sentar por una semana.
What? What does that mean?
It means ill-gotten gold is no one's gain. And furthermore, my son, if I catch you gambling, you won't be able to sit down for a week.
All right, so I won't gamble. I just want to see what the casino looks like.
No. Once you get in there, the temptation is irresistible.
Oh, how do you know?
I know. My father took me to Havana once.
So?
So I couldn't sit down for a week. Remember, no casino.
Why don't you just lock me in my room for the night?
Oh, no, honey, don't be silly. You can go and have dinner anywhere you want. And then go see a movie.
And you stay out of that casino too, Ethel.
Oh, with the money you give me, you don't have to worry.
It's not that. I'm afraid you might meet up with some prince and sweep him off his feet.
Well, I could. I might.
Well, good luck.